The following program contains mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Talking to your doc about your health problems can sometimes be very embarrassing, especially when the problem involves your private parts. But we've got you covered with hashtag AskTheGyno. Are you ready?
I'm always ready,
Dr. Nita, I can tell. Our first question is from a viewer who sent us this Snapchat. Take a look.
So I have a family vacation here in the next week, and it just happens that my period falls on the same time. Is there any way to delay my period?
Yeah, good question. Yeah.
So when someone comes in with this question and they're not on hormonal contraception, there is something you can give them called norethindrone acetate. It's a progesterone, and I'll typically start with 5 milligrams twice a day. They can start it about a week before their period is supposed to start, and they can continue it for the duration of their period. Some women will take this for endometriosis on a long-term basis, so you can take it even if your vacation is lengthier. I will say the longer you take it, the higher the risk of the breakthrough bleeding. So I tell patients, if you happen to have some bleeding, take an extra 5 milligrams per day. But I usually start at a lower dose because there are side effects, because so far it sounds too good to be true, right? Right. So most people do just fine with this medication, but potential side effects, which you really don't want on your vacation, would include things like acne, headaches, bloating, breast tenderness, or mood changes like feeling a little sad.
I would cancel that vacation.
Yeah, you would cancel. With all of that stuff, you're like, forget it, just give me my period.
I'd go fishing alone, maybe. I don't know what I do.
It is a hormone, so there are risks. And if someone has liver disease or if they've had blood clots or a stroke, this wouldn't be a great option for them. But definitely something you can talk to your doctor about. If you're on birth control pills, that's easy. Just skip those sugar pills. If you're using the NuvaRing instead of having, usually you put a NuvaRing into your vagina for 3 weeks, take it out for a week, have a period, you would just skip that week of the period, and then you would just put a new one in. If you're on other things like Mirena or you're using the Depo shot, it can get a little trickier, but talk to your doctor and there may be something they can help you out with.
Okay. So is it safe though? I mean, just for all of us listening and saying, wow, that sounds amazing. Is how long can you go without a period without worrying about it?
You don't have to have a period. So we can put people on contraception like the Mirena intrauterine device, and some people will stop having a period, and that stays in for 5 years. It's totally fine. Once upon a time, somebody said you need to wash it out, clean it out. I don't know what they said, but just throw that conversation in the trash can. You don't have to wash it out, clean it out, embrace it. It is okay to not have a period for several years, and then you should be able to get pregnant once you stop the hormonal contraception. The only hormonal contraception that can cause you to delay ovulation after stopping is medroxyprogesterone acetate. So that's one where you want to be a little more careful. And of course, people get older. So, you know, when you're 35, you're not 25 anymore. So you could have an issue getting pregnant, but it shouldn't be because you were on birth control for 10 years. It's not going to be because of that.